Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the United States, in Dallas, Texas area. Praise the Lord, we were able to arrive with no major incidences. By the grace of God, God's given us favor to arrive safely in the United States. We'll be heading out today to southern Louisiana, as the Lord has led me. And there's lots of people in the Dallas area who contacted me, and because we've only been here, 36 hours now, and it's 2 days travel to get here. So I told the people that I'll be looking to meet them on the way back out. I'll be going out of here on the 22nd of February, brothers and sisters. So I'll be looking to people who want to meet me in Dallas area, near the Dallas-Fort Worth airport area. It'll be on the 20th and 21st. To anyone else who I know who would contact me, who's a subscriber to the videos, let me know. Just private message me from the video link below, or email me. The links are below the video, and we can set it up. Some people, I guess, I'll try to meet individually, and some people, maybe if I run out of time, I can just meet people as a group. That's what I usually do. I try to see people one-on-one. Especially if I already know them, and then I'll have group gatherings and stuff. And as the Lord leads, if the church invites me, I'll go. I'll put it out there. People can come. So anyhow, by the grace of God, we'll be in going back out and going to California for 3 weeks. I'll be in the eastern part of California, about 2 hours from L.A., going toward the Las Vegas area. I'll be heading out. I think I'm going to go over to Las Vegas. I think I got to pray about it. My intention is to go to Las Vegas for a few days and see the brothers and sisters that I saw there. Have many subscribers to the YouTube channel in Las Vegas who I met with last time. And by the grace of God, I'll meet them again. Just let me know. That'll be the last week of February, first week of March. I'll be definitely, because they have this March Madness basketball stuff going on after March starts. So the last few days of February, first few days of March. Brothers and sisters, I praise the Lord that we'll see you there in Las Vegas. And then by the grace of God, I'm planning to meet with Brother Gary Bear 049, Minister Paul from YouTube, both those guys from YouTube that we'll meet. And it'll be a trifecta vortex of God's grace. you know, we might kick off you know, some major thing when if the meeting of the minds there in California. So praise the Lord for that. It'll be a blessing, and I'll be making a video by the grace of God, and then those guys, they can make one too, the three of us together. I think it's a blessing, you know, as the Word of God says in Psalm 133, how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It's like the beer, the oil that ran down Aaron's beard, even unto the hem of his garments. And, you know, really, as the Lord is our high priest, as is, you know, Aaron is a type of Christ, the high priest, which the Lord Jesus Christ is our high priest right now. Ever making intercession for us until he returns as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Till the tribulation begins, the Lord is seated right now at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us as our high priest. And then when the tribulation begins, he will stand up and begin to open the seals and pour out his wrath on this earth, preparation of the marriage supper of the Lamb and all those things. As the Lord leads me to make videos on these topics. Lots of people never heard teachings too much about the order of the tribulation period and all of that, and by the grace of God, I used to do pastor. Before I started Joshua's ministry, I did pastors' conferences on this kind of stuff in the Philippines, teaching on it a lot. And by the grace of God, the Lord will give me the opportunities to continue teaching and give me the unction to teach on the order of events of the tribulation period, as the Bible lays it out for us, brothers and sisters. I want to cut this off as a video of announcement. And I ask for your prayers and a prayer request for traveling mercies all the way through back to the Philippines, like the second week of March. We also found out that by talking to the immigration officer that, you know, you have to prove really that you're establishing a residency in the United States until my wife finishes her citizenship process, as I've mentioned before. But they are really, you know, even though they have a rule that if you come back in the United States within 1 year, that you know, you're good, but that's not really true. They also have lots of leeway, and it's open to interpretation. Even as, you know, when we came through Portland, Oregon, the immigration people were very nice, unlike all the other places I've come through, like in Detroit and Chicago. They're very rude and obnoxious, But I noticed that, and this is, I thought, that they're pretty laid-back kind of people in Portland. I've heard other places are laid-back too, like Hawaii and places like that. Anyway, so the guy was very nice, and he was telling us that it's just basically open to interpretation. If they have any inkling that, oh, you're spending, you know, you keep going out of the country, then they start investigating. Oh, you know, why are you doing that? So, of course, I'm doing mission work. But still, it's, especially with the increased level of persecution of Christians, and really particularly under President Obama, an unfriendly, just a general unfriendly stance toward Christianity and toward the Lord. It's, you know, it's an interpretive thing. If you go through immigrations and the local immigration guy is a God hater, which is highly possible nowadays, especially the government and the whole world is getting more and more, you know, God haters, who are people who are not Christian. It's becoming more of a dividing line, and it's all they got to do is just say, well, you know, now you've spent 4 months out of this year out of the country, we believe maybe you're not establishing a residency, you know, we're going to do some kind of investigation, and they can actually end up taking away your green card. You have to go through some processes and appeals and whatever, and it can cost money, time, and effort. And so anyway, as we were planning on moving back here to the States in June, it looks like we're going to do it after 2 months. He told me that, you know, we're going to just cut it off at 2 months this next visit. We should be good to go. But he cautioned against leaving the country anymore for the rest of the year. So, brothers and sisters, we need to let my wife finish up her 3 years of her green card status to get her citizenship. Then we won't have to worry about it anymore. So just pray for us. So it looks like every year we'll go 2 months to the Philippines, say, you know, every January and February for 2 months. That way we don't risk any, you know, getting a setback here, and because the cost, the hassle, and the hindrance to get a green card is very much and very something that you don't want to go through twice. So God bless you guys. I thank you. I got a video, a teaching that the Lord gave me. I just got through praying that I'm going to post now. I'll separate this. And before, as if you guys who watch my videos, I'll say stuff like, well, you know, people that don't want to hear and don't care and they're cold-hearted, which is true, and they don't care about the orphans, they don't care about Joshua's ministry, they don't care about me personally, they just want me to tell them what days of rapture is, and I would be in my own mind, in my own heart, that hey, I just want to share what the Lord's giving me with those who really have a loving heart, that don't just see me just, oh, he told me something about the Bible and now, you know, I just want to learn something about the Bible or something, but really care about me as a brother in Christ, or about Joshua's ministry, the orphans, and all that. But the Lord, that's what I'm going to make a video about. The Lord has been giving me this, basically the same dream, and speaking to me, I don't know how many times, just as I was waking up, maybe 4 or 5 times in the last 2 weeks. And basically the same message. And the message is he has got his people everywhere. So in other words, before the rapture will happen, okay, and only the Lord knows what the fullness of the Gentiles is. When's the last person to be saved? Okay, so the fullness of the Gentiles could be a million more people. It could be one more person. It could be a billion. I don't know. But only the Lord knows that. But the Lord has people in every segment. This is basically what the Lord was telling me. You know, he's got some prisoners in prison here who are drug dealers or killers, whatever, murderers, anything. Some of those guys are his. A remnant or whatever. There's a group of people who are prisoners who are the Lord's. There are a group of people in the homosexual community, even in San Francisco, the most, you know, wild, blatant, you know, I don't want to get into it, but anybody that drinks the Kool-Aid and believes that the homosexual community is just like looking for a monogamous relationship and want to get married and all that stuff. The whole point of the majority of this homosexual activity is just debauchery and perversion, and you know, they go to these bathrooms, like there's a senator, a Republican senator that just got in trouble for that a few years ago. They go to these bathrooms, these rest areas, and that singer from Wham, whatever his name is, George Michaels, also, there are millions of them like that, whatever, how many ever homosexuals there are, tons of them go to these rest stops and stuff looking for anonymous sex with each other and all this. It's like wild animals, just like dogs, you know, like Sodom and Gomorrah. And that's the truth that the media doesn't tell you and all that. The vast majority of them are just, you know, full of a demon of lust. That's what it's about, lust and just perversion and twisting God's creation of unity between a man and a woman in marriage. Anyway, So it's just the opposite of that, you know, the opposite of a man and his wife, and then the opposite of this monogamy and all that. It's just the devil twists it to the opposite. So anonymous sex with anybody you want to, and then also being a homosexual, sodomy. Anyhow, there's some of those people, even the most hardcore people that might have, you know, slept with a million other men or whatever they've done. There are some of those people who God has called, and the Lord will deliver, and they will repent, and they will change, and they'll be Christian. Okay, and then the rich people. There are a lot of rich people, like Bill Gates, he's an atheist or whatever. As Jesus said, it's hard for a, you know, it's easier for a camel to fit through the eye of a needle than a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. So, but there are rich people who are in need of nothing in this world, as Jesus told the parable of the rich man who said, well, you know, I have need of anything. My barns are full. I need to even tear down my barns and build bigger barns for all the stuff I've got. I'm set for life. I don't have nothing to worry about. And then Jesus said, you fool, your soul will be required of you this very night. So, you know, the riches of this world can't save you, but there are a few people. And like I said, this last time when I came to the States, I had an opportunity to work with some very rich people, and I observed it's really true what Jesus said. It's easier for that camel to fit through an eye of a needle than a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. Because of pride, arrogance, and the feeling that some privilege, and that you can own people, you can buy the gospel, you can buy preachers, you can control. And of course, the world is full of Joel Osteen's, and the prosperity gospel has went around the world where these preachers are owned, bought, and paid for to tickle the ears of those who have, for he who has money, let him give, you know, so that his ears may be tickled. So, but there are some of those people, just like any other group. Just as I mentioned, the prisoners, homosexuals, community, prison community, ultra rich in this world, even Bill Gates, maybe, I don't know, some of these ultra rich people, like those I just remember now, those of you who watch my videos, as I got to meet the co-founder of Apple and Steve Wozniak, as an example. These are God has his people everywhere. And what I'm trying to tell you is the Lord told me, hey, it's time for the rapture. Anytime now, and then I've got these little bit of people in every sector. So don't. What the Lord was telling me is, you know, don't say, hey, I don't want to talk to these prisoners. They're all a lost cause. I don't want to talk to these homosexuals. They're a lost cause. I don't want to talk to these rich people. They're a lost cause. I don't want to talk to Hispanic people or whatever, you know, or Filipinos, or they're all Catholic and they all worship Mama Mary and then the Santa Nina, the baby Jesus. They're all caught up into idolatry. So just let them go ahead and go. You know, you can't do anything with them. But what the Lord just keeps from telling me is that he has a remnant in each one of these groups. And then, you know, your middle class, you know, there's lots of other groups I didn't mention, okay? I just mentioned some specifically. But any group, the Lord showed me all groups, whomever they might be, from every dead denomination, from Catholicism. God has his people in Catholicism. The Lord has his people in the Presbyterians, the Lutherans, even the ones where they got the gay bishops and the and they renounce the word of God and all that. In there, Jesus has his wheat. Now, and I'm not saying that that's what I'm saying. They're not saved yet, but they're called to be saved. They're chosen by the Lord to be part of the bride. So that's what I'm saying. That's our commission. That's our mission. It's like the Lord gave me that book to write, the book that I wrote that you can order from Amazon or directly from me if you want a signed copy. And it's called Final Boarding Call, talking about Final Boarding Call for the Rapture. Tribulation's about to begin. Satan's plan for the ages, how he's going to, you know, the capstone of Satan's work will be the Antichrist, just like Jesus being here was the capstone of the work of Christ. And of course, when he returns and rules and reigns, of course, that's really the ultimate ends to the Lord's history, his story. And then our final mission, and that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm trying to tell you. The Lord has explained to me more clearly what is our final mission. Our final mission is to go into the highways and hedges and bring in those who are left. Okay, so let me cut this off and I'm going to make another video. And this video is for, you know, a general audience, you know, people who will not watch this video if I label it about prayer and all this kind of stuff. This next video will be for those people and, of course, for everybody. A word from the Lord.